first trip to Western Canada this coming week. Well, they have games against Calgary, Edmonton, and Vancouver. But before that, they've got a date tonight here against the Minnesota North Stars. Hello again, everybody. This is Ted Darling, along with Mike Robitaille. The North Stars are coming off a good 7-5 win over the Toronto Maple Leafs last night. The Sabres were idle. Last night, they did beat Vancouver on Friday night, Mike. But the North Stars could be a different hockey club than the first game they played when the Buffalo beat them 6-2.
Well, remember, they have a new coach this year in Lauren Henning, and that's going to be, there's going to be an adjustment period there for a while, but maybe everything's just starting to set in now for the Minnesota North Stars, and they're starting to find their way and finding how to win as a team. This is something that Henning is really trying to drive into their heads, that you need 18, 20 hockey players if you're going to be successful. He's trying to get away from that individual type of hockey that's been in Minnesota for so many years.
And the Buffalo Sabres, the other night, that game against the Vancouver Canucks, they had not been too successful at home. Steve Dykstra came into the lineup, and he told me the other night, Mike, that one reason why Schoenfeld benched him was the fact that he felt he was just being a little too comfortable back there, but he played well Friday.
Well, Jimmy's straightening out the rookies very quickly. I think that's a good move, too, by Jimmy Schoenfeld. He's not wasting any time. He's a talented hockey player, Steve Dykstra, and it must have worked, Ted, because I counted at least 10 solid hits in that hockey game, and he set up a beautiful goal. He played with a great deal of authority the whole 60 minutes. He was a big addition to that team in the last game.
Again, it'll be Tom Barrasso playing in goal for the Buffalo Sabres, and he's been in every game.
Well, once again, he's the best goaltender in the National Hockey League, and he's going to see plenty of work this season with the style of hockey that the Sabres are playing. Of course, Beaupre, on the other hand, he'll be playing for the Minnesota North Stars, an up-and-down type of career. I believe he is only 19 years old. Can you believe that? And he was an all-star in the National Hockey League. Then his career kind of tailed off a little bit. He had some trouble for a couple of years. Put it all together again, and now he's back up to his old tricks. They expect a great season from Beaupre this year.
Following this game tonight, off for three games on the road, and they'd like to leave here with a victory.
It's so important. You just leave in a good frame of mind, and to lose that last game at home, right in your home building here, is just devastating. And then you have to go on the road and try to win a game. It's very difficult, so they'll be gunning awful hard this evening.
Okay, Mike, and by the way, it's a Halloween costume party evening here at Memorial Auditorium. Should be interesting to take a look at all the costumes. Let's go inside right now. I wonder if Bruce Hood's wearing his face tonight.
Well, thanks, Ted. Yes, it is costume night tonight, and they often said I was a clown as a referee, so here I am. I've got my costume on. So, oh, what's that noise we hear? Well, for goodness sakes, it's King Kong from the Buffalo Zoo. Are you going to be playing tonight, King?
Can't wait. I can't wait to get out there, pal.
Have you got you in the lineup?
Well, supposedly. That's why I got down here. I had to break out of the zoo to get here.
I see. Well, listen, in case you don't get in the lineup, how about coming back at the end of the first period and be a guest analyst?
Well, I'll be kind of disappointed if I can't get in the game, but I'd love to do the replays.
Are you? Do you get excited when you watch hockey?
Oh, do I ever. I had to get real excited tonight to break the cells to get out.
Well, sounds like a lot of fun. We're looking forward to. Have you seen a hockey game before or played in a game or anything?
I've seen a couple back in the zoo, boy. They were rough ones. I'm getting really excited about this one.
Well, we'll look forward to having you on at the end of the first period. Well, stay tuned now for the live action with Ted and Mike. Well, you are watching Buffalo Sabres hockey.
A 6-2 score. That was the first road game for the Buffalo Sabres back on October the 12th. But now we are ready to begin play here, the first period. Not dressed tonight for the Buffalo Sabres, Mikael Anderson, Dave Fenfis, and Bob Halkidis. Sealing is playing at a center spot, Mike, to start this first period.
Interesting move, probably get some points out of him in that position.
With Langevin and Hughes on the wings, and on they draw. Here's Hughes at the far board, sends it in behind the Minnesota net. After number 21 for the North Stars, Graham flips it into the Buffalo zone, Sealing going in after it, and Minnesota called for icing, and that'll take the faceoff way back into the Minnesota zone.
Here's Tom Barrasso right there. Acton, it's at Boxborough High School. Isn't that something, right out of high school in the National Hockey League? Same thing with Phil Housley, Minnesota. That's an interesting line with Sealing at center, Langevin on one wing, and Hughes on the other. That's an awful good checking line, and you would think Sealing would be the natural pick for, if you're going to take a off the three, to put him at center.
Here's Sealing now. He's all down in the North Stars. Start to come back. Number 12, that is Acton. Now come back. Now right in front of the drive and firing that wide.
had a great opportunity, Scott Bukestad, but he shot it wide of the Buffalo net.
Right back with it is Hughes into the Minnesota zone, trailing Longeva, drop pass to Longeva, and Beaupre came through with a nice save there with the left hand, but it's kept into the long shot, he scores from the far boards, sending it in, off, Don Beaupre. And the Sabres have taken a 1-0 lead in that shot by Hughes.
Boy, some funny things happen sometimes, and that's all. Hughes scores his goal right here. It's just a real easy snapshot on the goal, and it might have caught the defenseman's stick and fooled the goaltender. And Beaupre just jumped up over his glove, and as it was going in, he still took another stab at it with the left hand, but it was too late.
And it's 1-0 Buffalo. I thought it was Hughes from the far board, but we're going to check on that in a moment.
I'm positive.
I think he was in front of the net, to tell you the truth, when that goal was scored. But we'll get the official out in a moment. It's 1-0 Buffalo. Andreychuk, he had just stepped down to the ice on that line. Andreychuk gets the goal. Here's a chance. Right through the goal crease. Back down to the right point. Out for the long drive. Deflected. Oh, right into the chest of Barrasso. It is still free. There's going to be a penalty coming to the Buffalo Sabres. Hauled down to the ice was Tom McCarthy in that scramble in front of the Buffalo net. And when we return, it'll be the North Stars in the power play. 1-0 Buffalo leading. This is Buffalo Sabres hockey. Out comes to center. Bellows gets it back to the Buffalo blue line, backing up his Ruck. Sends it to center. That's tipped back into the Sabre zone, with Ruck going in deep after it. He's watched by Kent Nielsen, number 15, coming over to the Minnesota North Stars this year from the Calgary Flames. Dykstra moves into the corner. Rook was after him. Around to Hartsburg. He fakes the shot, tried to get it into the faceoff circle. Now Marouk along the boards to the point now to Hartsburg. He slaps it in wide. Barrasso playing it around there. Hamel and Hartsburg are there. Hartsburg looked like that was an offside. Leon Stickel, though, the linesman was right there, and it's cleared back into the Minnesota zone. Now the North Stars try to come back, but Foligno keeps it in. Here goes Perreault, and Foligno right in front of the backhand shot. He scores! Assisting, Foligno gets his fifth goal of the year, and it's 2-0 Buffalo.
It was an excellent shot by Foligno, but what tremendous work right there by Gilbert Perreault to put it right on his stick with a man on top of him. That was an absolutely deadly pass. Watch how he lays it right on his stick. Exactly, it's just perfect. He skates right into it, takes a cross check, still finds the open corner. Boy, it's that teamwork right there. Minnesota finding themselves in a hole early here. Sabres up by 2 goals, still early in the first period.
Stepping it over the Minnesota blue line, looking back, he gives it to Perreault. Takes the shot, the drive, he scores! Gil Perreault! Sabres take a 3-0 lead. I don't know whether Mike Foligno got his stick up or not. It seemed to change direction to the last second, but...
Or change of pace. Here it is right here. I think the puck jumped up on him. He's expecting a harder shot, but possibly it might have caught Mike Foligno on the hand. But let's have another look at it here. It's almost like he was going to drill it harder, and he just caught the top of the puck and zipped right underneath the glove hand of Beaupre. But that just might have been a simple change of pace on Beaupre and fooled him.
Gilbert Perreault has given Buffalo a 3-0 lead as Perreault picks up his 4th goal of the season. Here's the announcement.
Buffalo needs all they can get against this hockey club.
Now Foligno coming back, and remember, the Sabres are still on a power play situation with 1:08 remaining the penalty to shoot Graham.
And I'm John Murphy. Join us every Monday night at 8:30 in your local cable station for Buffalo Bills Magazine. Each week we'll have an in-depth review of the Bills game along with other NFL action. Plus, we'll have an in-depth look and profile on player, coach, or personality from around the National Football League.
Along with a complete analysis of the Buffalo Bills' upcoming opponent.
That's Buffalo Bills Magazine every Monday night at 8:30, right before Monday Night Football, here on your local cable station.
Excuse me, I was just with my friend here, the Big Ape. I had to play with him on defense. Now I have to work with him. That's why my job's so tough. Jerry Korab, I've never seen you look so good.
Thanks, Mike. You know, I went in and I got specially made up for this game. It was my big night tonight.
Well, what are you going to do about it? Is there anything special other than this?
Well, I'd like to get out there and play, and it looks like the North Stars need some help tonight.
Listen, what about Minnesota? Jerry, I was telling Bruce, a very unpredictable team. Sometimes the problem is maybe a team has too many stars, or they just don't seem to play as a unit.
I think on the whole, the Minnesota North Stars, as in the past, they're, like you said, they're very unpredictable, and they've just been playing like that for about the last 5 or 6 years. I think, you know, they got 5 or 6 good players out there that they're going to have to rely on, and if those 5 or 6 players don't perform, they're not going to do too well.
Who do you think those 5 or 6 players would be? Who are their key men?
Well, you guys like Dino Cicerelli, of course, he's not playing tonight, and Willie Pletz out of the lineup. You got Craig Hartsburg, he's the backbone of the defense. Players like that and their goaltender, Beaupre, they're going to have to get top performances out of them.
This is really, it's really difficult. I'll tell you what, you take the mask off and I'll show you the replays. Is that fair enough?
Fair enough.
Okay, let's get it off and we'll get to work. Here's the first goal right here by Dave Andreychuk. Take it, Jerry.
On the first goal here, Andreychuk just sort of, I think he's just trying to dump it at the net. And Beaupre, I don't know, he must have been sleeping or something and just gets by him. You know, it was a lucky goal for us, but like I said earlier, in the last game, all the goals count. This is the same goal here from an upper angle, and you'll see he just flips it at the net. I don't know if it hit the defenseman's stick here or not, but obviously Beaupre was asleep or something on this one.
I mean, it didn't take too long for Buffalo. They came roaring back with one, I believe it was 5:56, and this time it was Mike Foligno from who else but Gilbert Perreault.
On this play here, Gilbert, once again, he gets the puck in the corner, and he makes a perfect pass out to Mike Foligno. And you got to give Mike a lot of credit here. He not only scored the goal, he obviously at first had kept it. And here's Bert now. He just dumps it out in front. A lot of hard work here and effort by Mike Foligno. He dives and he still puts the puck in net. Can't say enough about it. We're going to see this goal again from a different angle. Here it is again. Mike breaking for the net. Right in a perfect place run. And he puts it in on his backhand as he's falling down. It just shows you the kind of concentration he had on this goal.
Yeah, that was really tough. He didn't have much time either, and he was falling with the man checking him. Then, exactly. Once again, Perreault picks up another point, and what a beautiful goal that was.
Tremendous. On this next goal, the one that Bert gets, he puts on a fantastic deke on a defenseman. And obviously on this play, the defenseman, he just turns away from it. Bert gets the puck. He's walking in. Now watch this fake. The defenseman turns away. Bert comes in, walks around him. He just takes that big slapper and puts it right in the net. We're going to see it once again here. Here comes the pack, and it's Andreychuk. Passes out to Bert. He walks in. Watch a nice little fake. Defenseman, you know, he just turns away out of the play. He's gone. All of a sudden, Bert steps over, walks in front, gets a better shot, and just blows it by him. Another tremendous goal by Gilbert Perreault.
But, you know, Minnesota have had many opportunities. He certainly deserved to at least have one or two goals. And but it seems Tom Barrasso is coming out an awful lot, Jerry, and taking the good shots away from the Minnesota players. They're in the right position, but they have nothing to shoot at except they hit Tom Barrasso.
Exactly. You know, like I said last game, if the Sabres are going to play offensive, the other team's going to obviously going to get chances. And like you said earlier, Minnesota did have a couple of very good opportunities. They ran into a brick wall. Tom Barrasso came up big again.
You see a lot of confidence in this hockey club, Jerry, in the Buffalo Sabres hockey club, or did you see a more confident team last year?
Well, I think they're getting more confidence each game, and especially, you know, the style they're playing, very offensive. And like I said, with Tommy Barrasso back there, the more saves that he makes, the more confident the players are going to end. They're going to take a lot more chances and score more goals.
Okay, Jerry, we'll see you next period.
Thanks, Mike.
We'll be right back for more second period hockey action. Sabres in the lead, 3-0, and you're watching Sabres Hockey.
Our intermission guests receive an assortment of Christian Dior 100% silk neckwear, compliments of Rooties, Buffalo's favorite chicken wing eatery, Millersport Highway at Campbell Boulevard, Amherst. Choosing wings, choose Rooties. It's Buffalo's favorite chicken wing eatery. Guests also receive a gift from Panasonic, courtesy of Orville Appliance Warehouse.
Good night, Fuzz. We're all depending on you. I gotta guard these Panasonic VCRs and TVs. Boy, they sure sell a lot of Panasonic video equipment at Orville's Appliance Warehouse. It must be the low prices, or maybe the huge selection of Panasonic equipment.
Orville's Appliance Warehouse, North Bailey Avenue, Amherst, Seneca Street, West Seneca.
Trying to get away. Oh, we've got Dykstra and Orstar in a battle. Steve Dykstra. And number 5, that is Dave Richter. Oh, look at them, standing toe-to-toe.
Dykstra won't give up either. He caught a couple of good ones. Look at this. This is one of the best fights we've ever had.
And Richter with the helmet on, still had his helmet on. Boy, did they fire away.
I thought Dykstra was going to go down 2 or 3 times, and he didn't. He just held his feet and came back and kept firing. Holy smokes, what a battle.
We'll return to the auditorium in just a moment with Buffalo leading by 3-0. This is Buffalo Sabres hockey. Housley keeps it inside the blue line. He shot it off Broten. Now cleared to center. Owsley trying. It's picked by Broten going into the breakaway all alone. He scores. Neil Broten. Now the Sabres are furious, going after referee Ron Hogan.
I don't know what they're furious about.
Well, Mike Ramsey, he's being held away by the linesman.
Well, here it is right here, okay? Owsley tries to take him down. He gets out-muscled for the puck. That's what happened. Broten just out-hustled him for it. Went in on the breakaway. Everything's clean so far. Takes the shot, and in it goes. It must have happened way down at the other end because I really don't know what the complaint is about. Well, here it is right here. Now, the two of them are working for the puck. Now, who's going to get it? Broten does. Moves in. Nothing to cry about so far, so it had to happen way down at the other end.
Well, Mike Ramsey kept looking back at the referee when Broten was going after that puck, and Owsley, he kept looking back. You could see him in that replay going back up the ice, but Broten has put the North Stars on the scoreboard with his fourth goal of the season, and Buffalo has a 3-1 lead.
As I mentioned earlier, Broten is one of the key players on this hockey club, and they really have to have him playing well if they're going to be successful this year.
Period. McKenna. Back to the line. Graham, he's checked from behind, sends it into the Buffalo zone. There goes Height. The North Stars have managed just 16 shots on Tom Barrasso. And Playfair almost gave it to Broten. There's a pass. Here's Broten getting it in front. Side of the net. Here's McCarthy getting it out in front. Knocked down. Hartsburg's there. 37 seconds to go. Graham. Now Havel attempting to clear it. Comes along the boards. Acton gets it back to Giles. He dumps it in front. Oh, tipped it wide. They score! Neil Broten gets his second goal of the game, and it's a 3-2 score. Don't count the North Stars out yet. They had pulled their goaltender in favor of the extra attacker. 28 seconds to go, and the North Stars are not finished yet. Should they be able to clear it back into the Buffalo zone? Watch again. Now it comes around to Giles. He took a drive, and it's knocked down. Then it's flipped wide to the net. Now look at Barrasso. There he is, down, out of position completely when he tried to go after the one save. And Broten just tucks it in the open side. It's 3-2, 28 seconds to go. And now a timeout has been called by Buffalo. And the Sabres a little upset, obviously, with the fact that Broten got in there to tip it into the open side. McCarthy and Giles assisting at 19:32. 7 seconds remaining. McCarthy on the board. Can't clear it against Seeling. 8 seconds. Still kept inside the line. 5 seconds remaining. 4-3-2. That's it. The Buffalo Sabres have defeated the Minnesota North Stars by 3-2. After a late goal by the North Stars and Tom Barrasso being congratulated for his fifth victory of the season against 3 losses and 1 tie. He faced a total of 17 shots in the third period. Buffalo had 7 and Minnesota had 4. Overall, Sabres with 45 shots, the North Stars with 17. And Broten scoring twice for Minnesota. For Buffalo, all the scoring came in the first period. Andreychuk with his 6th of the year unassisted. Foligno with his 5th of the year. And Perreault with his 4th of the year. Perreault with a 2-point night, 1 goal and 1 assist. Craig Ramsey waiting for Bill Haik to leave the ice and the rest of the Sabres. And they go to the dressing room with 2 points tucked away as they begin now their trip westward. In just a moment, we'll have the 3-star selection here at Memorial Auditorium.
And now for tonight's selections. The 3rd star with 42 saves on 45 shots to Minnesota's Don Beaupre. And the 2nd star with 1 goal to Buffalo's Mike Foligno. And the 1st star with 1 goal and moving to 8th in NHL history with his 777th assist to Buffalo's Gilbert Perreault.
There they are, the 3 stars. Your director tonight has been Paul DeWall. The producer, Dean Galanka. Perreault, Foligno, Beaupre.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back once again to the post-game show, and also welcome to the Gilbert Perreault show. Gilbert, this is getting to be a habit. Are the guys teasing you in the dressing room? Say, how about let us have a turn?
Well, you know, it's after every game, you know, it seems that I got the 1st star, but there's other players on the team, you know, and they would like to come on TV, and, you know, I'm getting to be very shy about it.
Yeah, they're getting to know your face around here, too. Listen, all the shots you had in goal, I believe you had 45 shots in net. That's almost enough to win three hockey games, yet the game ended up being very close near the end. It was nip and tuck.
Well, you know, that goalie, we had a lot of shots, but all the shots we had, we didn't have anybody in front, you know. Like, their defense, they did a good job pushing our guys in front. The goalie saw all the shots, you know. We kept shooting really high, too, and he's really good. Beaupre is really good.
Well, we're going to have a look at one of your breakaways right near the end of the game, one you didn't manage to put in, but have a look at this, and what do we got here, Joel?
Well, right there, you see, I started to slow down, and I was really tired. I just couldn't go anymore.
What a man.
And that guy just, well, the guy did a great play, you know. That was the play to do.
Great defensemen, aren't they? Aren't they wonderful to have defensemen on your team? They're doing a lot of work also. I noticed this season they're moving up with the forwards an awful lot. That's something they didn't do too much last year, but they're moving right up on the play with you guys. That has to make your job a little easier.
Well, you know, that's the way we have to play hockey. It's like that today. Every team is playing like that, and we have to get used to that kind of play, because we don't want, especially in Buffalo, we don't want to go back in our zone. And you know, when you get when we go back in our zone, that makes 10 players in our zone, and that's hard to come out of there.
Important to win before going on the road?
Very important, you know, especially at home. We've been having problem here, and now we're going on the road. It's going to be good, you know, good spirit, good attitude, and okay. Let's hope to win.
Nice of you to join our crew this year, Gilbert. We're going to put you on the payroll. Sabres win a squeaker tonight, 3-2. We'll be right back with the play of the game, and you're watching Sabres Hockey.